the way we make live entertainment, whether it is theater, live music, dance, or the indescribable, is changing. The technology we use is changing, and the way we interact with lighting is changing. We need tools that can make us more efficient, tools that enable us to keep up with the fast-paced demands of an intensive tech session, and tools that will enable us to visualize and control our lighting in new ways. You've probably watched the Eos Augment3d tutorials and looked at the software, and then you may have decided, it's just too complicated, or that you don't have the time to learn 3D. I am here to dispel some of the myths that exist around the use of Augment3d. Before we go any further, I'll tell you that this is not a how to use Augment3d session. It is all about why you should use Augment3d and how you can get started today. Here are the myths that we'll be busting today. Number one, Augment3d is really complicated to set up. Number two, I have to already be proficient in 3D drawing and CAD packages to even use Augment3d. Number three, in order to use Augment3d, I have to import my whole lighting plot. Number four, pen and tilt just don't work anymore. Now I have to use XYZ palettes. And number five, Augment3d is just another visualizer. So right off the bat, I'm going to take a cue out of order and correct myth number five. Augment3d is not just a visualizer. It really is a 3D programming tool. Visualizers are intended to get you as far as a load-in. After that, they generally stop being very useful. Augment3d allows you to keep working, or even start working in a 3D space while you are programming, bringing you a bunch of really useful tools that are intended to make your life, or at least your programming, easier. We'll circle back to this idea a lot as we go through this session. So, myth number one, it's just too complicated. I guess the answer here is baby steps. Like any new piece of software, you need to allow some time to learn the features and how they can help you to work smarter and faster. The thought of having to draw your space in 3D can be daunting, but you don't have to. All Augment3d really needs for you to get going is a floor, with basic dimensions that you probably already have in your head. I think of it as a bit like Magic Sheets, a tool that you didn't know you needed until it became available. And now, I haven't heard of a single show that doesn't have at least one Magic Sheet in the show file. People found that Magic Sheets were all about creating personalized, reusable programming tools. It's the same with Augment3d. And this is our challenge to you. Start small. Find one thing that you want to do. It could be as simple as a single light in a single queue, and build that into Augment3d. If it solves your problem and allows you to keep on programming, you're on the right path. Regarding myth number two, you do not need to be a CAD wizard to use Augment3d. If you have drawings, then great, but you don't need them. There are stock items included in Augment3d that you can use to get you going, and remember, all you really need is a floor. You can include as much or as little detail as you need in your model. Sure, there's great value in having a millimeter accurate Augment3d model with all the details in there, but my advice would be, if you don't need it, then don't include it. If the set designer's done a great 3D model and you're able to import it, go for it. It is worth remembering that the more accurate your model is, the more accurately you can interact with Augment3d, but the more complex the model you're importing, the more measurements there are that you might need to get checked and corrected. And if all you really need is the size of the stage and a few different levels, then just add those. Remember, you are not really using Augment3d as a visualizer, but as a tool to get you the three-dimensional control of the lights that you want. Always ask yourself, how much do I actually need? You can always add extra elements in as you go, and as you learn, the faster you will become, just like with any other tool. Myth number three, you need your entire rig built into Augment3d. If all you need is to get some movers to go from point A to point B in a straight line, then you don't need to spend hours drawing in the set and the rest of the rig in full detail. Just add in the floor and the lights you need, and you're ready. Or maybe you have some LED battens behind a piece of scenery or a psych, and you want to see what those lights are doing, or ballet booms that are hidden from view by the masking, or some practicals or other lights that aren't always plugged in. Just add those and don't worry about the rest, at least for now. being selective about the lights you pull into Augmented means that you don't need to spend time setting focus for every single fixture. Using Click to Focus is another tool that helps speed up your process. We often create a 9-point starter grid for moving light positions before we even start programming. Having a quicker way to do this means you have more time to finesse some of the other details that maybe you wouldn't normally get time to get back to. Using fixture POV in Augmented to check a fixture's line of sight can also save time. You can be sure that you're going to get the shot you need before you spend time getting out a ladder and rigging a real light. Okay, myth number 4. Let's talk about pan and tilt versus XYZ palettes. Think of it this way. Traditional pan and tilt palettes basically store just that, pan and tilt values of a light. XYZ palettes store where the actual emitted light should be, an XYZ point. But even if you are using Augmented, you do not need to have XYZ palettes. Over time, you can ease yourself into them, as there are some distinct benefits over conventional pan and tilt palettes. As an example, think about those bi-type palettes that you've been using for a while for gobos and zooms and colors. Using XYZ, you can finally make use of bi-type palettes for focus position information. Focus palette 42 is a chair, for example. A bunch of lights can hit that chair. Now you don't need to adjust all of them when that chair gets moved. It also gives you a way to interact with the fixtures in a real-world way. Move those lights 2 meters further upstage, or the truck has just moved 1 foot stage left. Update the bi-type focus palette, and all the lights now know where to hit. But you don't have to use XYZ palettes to still use XYZ. You can continue to store palettes as pan and tilt, but use the tap to focus and fixture handle functions to move groups of lights without even knowing that those are XYZ under the hood. So back to myth number 5. Hopefully by now you are starting to see Augmented as more than just a visualizer, and that it's a powerful set of programming tools. And I really hope that I've dispelled some of the myths around using Augmented. While it does go far beyond what you can expect from a visualizer, you don't have to go from zero to full in a snap cue. Your Augmented journey can be a nice, smooth crossfade. Thanks.